मैंने इनफैक्ट परसों ही कुणाल के साथ भी एक पॉडकास्ट रिकॉर्ड करा है. कुणाल के साथ भी आई रिकॉर्ड एन एपिसोड. सो
अच्छा
आई मीन या वी जस्ट हैड अ लॉन्ग चैट अबाउट एवरीथिंग. बाय चांस है कि आपके साथ भी और कुणाल के साथ इतने शॉर्ट नोटिस पे हो रहा है, जबकि आई वाजंट इवन डूइंग दिस फॉर अ मेरा मैंने थोड़े टाइम के लिए गैप लिया हुआ था. तो इट्स अ कोइंसिडेंस
ओके,
आप दोनों के साथ सेम टाइम पे हुआ. सो
कुणाल
एनीवे
इज एक्सट्रीमली रिवेटिंग है. इज एक्सट्रीमली इज अ गाय हु नोज एग्जैक्टली व्हाट ही इज डूइंग. सो
या
इट्स अमेजिंग for me to have conversations with. I mean, all our conversations kind of ends up telling me the kind of clarity that he has. He's somebody with like amazing clarity. I mean, he knows exactly. मतलब एक अगर जंग में घोड़ा उसके तरफ अगर दौड़ते हुए आएगा तो उसको पता है कि उसको लेफ्ट कूदना है कि राइट कूदना है कि घोड़े के ऊपर चढ़ के घोड़े को ही कब्जा करना है. He knows it is that clear.
No,
And
he's amazing in the film as well.
he's got amazing improv capabilities. You know, so I'm saying that
All right.
it's a certain comfort that you have with the craft. It's a certain comfort that you have with which your experience has given you, and it's a certain comfort that your wit over the years that gives you. You wit is not something which just happens to people, and you know you're not just born with it. It's also a function of how you keep sharpening it at every
Right.
level on a daily basis. What do you do to keep your wit sharp, right? So he's, to me, is like an amazing, amazing guy to know. If I had not known him as a filmmaker, right, it would have been still a great guy to know.
हाँ नहीं, बल्कि मेरी उनसे ये भी बात हो रही थी कि लाइक ही इज ऑल्सो समबडी हु इज सो फैसिनेटेड एंड एनामर्ड बाय सिनेमा दैट ही ऑल्सो वॉन्ट्स टू एट सम पॉइंट ट्राई टू राइट एंड मेक फिल्म्स एज वेल.
So
सो
he's already writing. He's already written some stuff, and he's, let me tell you, he's quite a good writer.
राइट
If
राइट
you look at Go Gogon credits, and then there's a couple of other material which he's kind of shared with me, was nice enough to share with me some really good stuff out there. So as somebody who, I mean, I think he just looks at himself as the moment he gets, you know, you throw a challenge at him, he looks at it, he says, "Ki, let's see what I can do with this." He doesn't get intimidated.
Correct.
You know, a lot of people look at it and say, "No, man, but I don't think I have the training for this. I'm not sure if I've had the right education for this. I'm not sure if I need to know more about this." He just looks at it at a very wit level and says, "Okay, let me, from my understanding, see if I can take a shot at this." And that's a great quality, not only for people who work in films, but also it's a great entrepreneurial skill that most people kind of lack.
Absolutely.
You know, and then as a filmmaker, you have to be an entrepreneur, man. I mean, in the sense that every day is like an enterprise.
Yeah.
Every day you're going out there, venturing into something. You have a plan, you have a master plan, you have a map of what you're going to navigate, but you don't know how it's going to turn out. I know I have to reach from year to year, but raste mein thagi mil gaye to main kya karu? Do I fight them? Do I charm them? Do I con them?
Yeah.
Do I get bullied? Do I play the fool? I still have to go to the other side. And that's like, you know, more true in this business than anything else. I'm sure, I mean, every other walk of life, they have their own version of
correct
dealing with a situation, but nothing goes the way you plan in a set. Even if it's like a controlled set, even if it's like a, if it's whether it's a controlled set environment, studio environment, whether it's a real location, which is why there's a lot of respect for guys in a business who can forecast disaster. Our line is, there is a plan. Everybody likes a plan. There is a script. There are dialogues. There's costumes. There's sets. There's lighting. There's camera. And then there's a director who says, "I want you to say it a little faster, a little slower. Can you emote a little more? Can you walk across the camera when you say that?" And sounds simple, right? But when you sit down to do it, because there are human beings involved, correct? You can, you know, you can have problems right from a toothpick to an elephant. That can go wrong. It's
correct.
Not necessarily just the elephant that needs to, like, you know, come in and barge and destroy a set. But somebody could have a problem with the way you're even using a toothpick. The actor could just say, "Listen, man, this is not working." And you want to say, "Why isn't it working?" You know, "Because it's not going in my teeth." Really? And then you realize that it's a real problem. And somebody who was supposed to look into it has not looked into it. Somebody has just done like a tick box job of it, basically. So when you ask a production assistant, you know, when the hero is saying that line, "I wanted to kind of, you know, feel very cool and put a toothpick in his mouth and say that," he's just gone and gotten a toothpick of the wrong size. It's just not sharp enough. Maybe it's too brittle or whatever. He's just not taken it out, tried it on himself and said, हाँ ये सही रहेगा.
Yes.
और spoken to me saying, sir, कि ये problem हो सकता, ये हो सकता है तो मैं चार अलग sizes के toothpick लाऊं क्या? उसके अंदर एक प्लास्टिक भी आता है, उसके अंदर एक वुड भी आता है, वो लेके आऊं क्या? Somebody is not thought through.
Correct.
And that there is your problem with the toothpick. And I'm sorry, I'm just giving you like you know an analogy basically. But yeah.
Nahin, sorry, sir,
let's shoot, man. Let's start.
Are
you already in the chat?
Yeah, in a way, because मेरे को लगा कि better है कि हम लोगों ने organically अपने आप ही start हो गई conversation. और सर मतलब इट्स अ वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट वेरी इंटरेस्टिंग पॉइंट दैट यू ब्रॉट अप बिकॉज द ग्रेट जर्मन फिल्म मेकर वर्नर हर्ज़ोग ही ऑफ्टन टॉक्स अबाउट हाउ मतलब ही इज वेरी स्ट्रांगली अपोज टू द आइडिया ऑफ द ट्रेडिशनल वे ऑफ टीचिंग फिल्म एट फिल्म स्कूल्स और उनके जो खुद के फिल्म स्कूल्स हैं उसमें भी वो फिल्म की आर्ट और क्राफ्ट से ज़्यादा ही एक्चुअली टॉक्स अ लॉट अबाउट कि एक फिल्म पे कैसे हसल किया जाता है व्हेन यू आर यू नो अगर आपको एक जगह पे एक लोकेशन पे शूट करना है तो फिर उस लोकेशन के जो ओनर्स हैं उनके साथ कैसे नेगोशिएट किया जाए वगैरह वगैरह सो दैट्स द काइंड ऑफ कन्वर्सेशन दैट ही ऑलवेज ट्राइज टू हैव और उनकी मास्टर क्लास वगैरह में भी हर जगह पे वो यही चीज के बारे में बात करते हैं कि दिस इज व्हाट यंग फिल्म मेकर्स नीड टू टुडे लर्न मोर देन द आर्ट एंड द क्राफ्ट इटसेल्फ व्हिच कैन बी सेल्फ लर्नड एज वेल सो क्या आपको लगता है कि दिस इज अ पर्सपेक्टिव एंड अ फोरसाइट दैट मोर यंग फिल्म मेकर्स नीड टू हैव.
See, I'll tell you, I've yet to see this masterclass of Werner Herzog. I mean, I have a lot of admiration for him. I mean, I think somewhere in 2008 or 2009, was it the Time magazine that said that this is the most important filmmaker of our time?
Yeah.
And that's Werner Herzog. In the sense that Werner Herzog has yet to make a bad film. Even his bad films apparently are extremely interesting.
Yeah.
Correct. And there's something to learn in that, even in those failures. So I've been reading about him for a bit. I've seen him in some movies. I've seen him play some shady character in Jack Reacher and such.
Right.
I love the way he talks. When I was in the prison, there was a certain way that people would describe me. Right. And I also watched him in Firewatch. So, you know, I get what he's saying. It is, I think, it's not just with the young generation filmmaker. Right? I mean, I know. The other day, I knew a friend of mine who lives in Pune said that there's a really big filmmaker who basically was given a location to shoot at. He was given this really nice, he hired like this colony to shoot at. You know, Pune has this really nice gated complex kind of a place. I'm sure every city now has that.
Right.
And he was shooting with, with an actress and... So there were these predestined places that they were given, you know, predetermined places that they'd chosen after doing a recce. And it suddenly so turned out that he wanted to shoot in a particular house, which turned out to be the house of a really senior honcho working in a corporation. Okay. And that guy expressed surprise saying that, you know, how dare this guy came to me and said, I want to shoot in your house. And when my friend said that, you know, this filmmaker guy is a nutcase. He wanted to shoot in this real super senior Fortune 500 company CEO's house. On a very short notice. And I said, so what's wrong with that? So he said, what do you mean what's wrong with that? He's not gone through proper channels. I said, you know, if you had to look at going through proper channels in life, you would have never made a single film, including advertising films. The kind of hustle that you have to pull off on a daily basis just to survive in this business. I mean, I said, what are we really selling? You're selling an idea which does not have a, I can't give you a demonstration. If I go to buy a flat, I get to see a sample. If I want to buy tomatoes, I stand with the bhajiwala and the bhajiwala says, the sabjiwala says, tomato, you're asking kitne ke, he says, 20 rupees kilo, 40, I don't know what the reality is, 50 rupees kilo. I get to hold a tomato. I get to see the tomato. Right. What am I selling a producer? Right. What am I selling the consumer before the film gets made? What am I selling the audience? So it's all in the air. It's a wispy idea. It's imagination. Correct. It's a small thought I have one day in the morning. I write it down. I even see that it could be an interesting story. So I write 3 pages of it. See if it has a head, body and a tail. Nice conflict. Goes into complication. Nice resolution. I try talking to my writer friend. He says, yeah, that kind of sounds interesting, but I don't like the ending or I don't like the beginning. And then I say, okay, go out there, expand on it. And then he expands on it. The three-pager even becomes like a 30-pager because he's now expanded, added more characters, added some dialogues, added like interesting twists in the screenplay. And that kind of sounds nice. And then we say, great, now how do we develop this into a script? Then we sit down, we jam. What if this character said this? No, no, but what if this character is like this? He doesn't say this and he says this. And then what have you? You have an 80 to 90 page script. And now you're selling. You're selling a script which you can hold and which is it's binded. But you're selling an idea. If I went and said, I can't ask Amir because Amir will never do it. And I meet Amir 5 years later in the studio and he says, that's a damn good idea, man. I wish you had come to me with it. Imagine what an idiot I'll feel like. At that point in time, it feels like a hustle. If I go to Amir Khan, I go to whoever the top A-listers are, doesn't get better than an Amir Khan in the business. And you shouldn't be in a situation where you said, I wish I had asked him. I wish I had asked that CEO for his house for a shoot. What if the guy just, instantly connected with me and said, you're that guy who made that film. I really enjoyed it. And what else do you do? And I say, I enjoy, would you like to have a cup of tea? And then I'm chatting with him. And next thing is, I always wanted to know. It was a function of not having asked him.
Correct.
So it's the regret of not having asked is what you're going to be living with for the rest of your life. So you better pull that hustle. You don't have a choice. Poochne mein kya harj hai? Pooch lo na. So everything is a function of that.
Right.
Actor ko bhi pooch lo ek bar aap chalte chalte. Aapka jeb mein se aap cheez nikal rahe ho. और उसको ओपन कर रहे हो लेकिन बगल में आप साइड में कुछ देख रहे हो और किसी के साथ बात कर रहे हो और ये जब से आपने एक सिगरेट निकाल लिया से लाइट कर लिया ये कर सकते हो क्या? I know it's an impossible ask and if you look at method acting and stuff like that they'll tell you boss just method acting is fundamentally at some basic level just remember your lines and mind the furniture. At one level that's what they say. Right? And don't make it so complicated that an actor has to start figuring out how am I going to feel saying these things. But let's say I said that to an actor and the actor said what? Actually, it's possible. I remember shooting with Dhoni commercials and I believe he's easily one of the best
actors.
He's probably even better than a lot of actors that I've shot with.
Yeah.
So I'd give him a situation, I'd say, I want you to walk with the bag, then turn around, leave this, do this. And do you think I will steal the line? He'll just look at me for a second and he'll say, ek baar aur karke dikhayenge sir. So I'll do that for him. Do you think I can do that? He says, koshish karke dekhte. And trust me, 9 out of 10 times, he'll actually hit the mark. वो करके दिखाएंगे वो तो मेरे लिए क्या है कि पूछने में क्या हर्ज है. Sometimes the hustle is just that. लड़की सुंदर है आपने भी देखा मैंने भी देखा बस में बैठे हम दोनों. अब ये बंदा ने जस्ट पूछा लड़की को वो हासिल हो गई यार मैंने कोशिश किया यार इट्स वर्थ ट्राइंग.
Yeah.
No, I'm saying. So you didn't ask your problem, but I asked. And you know what the girl said? Yes. I will go out for a coffee with you. So sometimes it's just that, and you have to remember that the rewards are far greater than the effort that you put into it.
Yeah.
So you look at things from that perspective. When a couple of things work for you is when you realize, Jesus, you want to kick yourself up for not having hustled all the times when you had the chance.
Yeah.
And then you did not because you were too shy or you were too proud or, you had your head up in your ass saying, you are the loser. So it's not just for this generation. I would say that this is something which everybody needs to do, not just in filmmaking, but in real life.
Kisi bhi tarike ki profession mein.
Har profession mein zaruri hai yaar. Hai na? Yahan pe thoda dikhta hai. Matlab ek bar film ban jati hai, to fir log dekhte hain, bolte hain, haan, fir kahaniyan banti hai uske par. Then those become stuff of legends. You know what, actually he didn't have the right to shoot there, but the way he went and spoke to the CEO. But sometimes the guy just buys into your cause and you just need to be sincere. You don't need to lie to him. Hustle also has a negative connotation, which is that, he went and lied and conned him, saying, "Chori, shot le lete hain. Aap background mein baithi, aap bhi aa jaoge film ke andar." Usse karne ki zarurat nahi hai. Agar aap usko apna vision dikha doge, aur bande ne, so good possibility na bhi kahega. But at least I'm sleeping well at night, saying, "I tried."
True.
I genuinely tried. It didn't work out. Doesn't matter. But that doesn't, make me lose faith in humanity and my ability to go and ask sincerely. I will keep doing that.
Right. Yeah.
So sometimes it's just a function of that.
Yeah.
People call it hustle. I call it trying.
अच्छा सर, not talking particularly about the influence and impact of films on your life, like was it always there? Did you always have the cinema ka keeda jab aap chote the, ya fir kis point pe shuru hua, aur kaun si film hai wo jinka aapke upar sabse zyada impact raha hai?
Wo kehna bahut mushkil hai yaar. I got into film. I have a few friends who were very clear at the age of 16, 17 that they wanted to be filmmakers.
Achha.
16, 17 के अंदर तो मतलब मैं मेरे को अकल भी नहीं थी. मैं रीड करता था काफी. I used to read a bit. गली क्रिकेट खेलता था, करेक्ट. और वो भी मतलब रबर बॉल टेनिस बॉल वाली गली क्रिकेट खेलता था. हाँ, यहाँ वहाँ बीच में कहीं हॉकी वॉकी खेल लेता था जाके एक दो जगह में. फिल्में देखते थे हम लोग. I remember watching a lot of films, and I was fortunate to be in a company. So Bombay mein colonies hote hain, apartments hote hain, right? Suburbs ke andar. But I was very fortunate to be in a company of people who watch good films.
Achha.
Pretty decent films. I mean, you know, not just a popular variety. Lot of them were given to reading. I knew I wanted to write, but coming from a, you know, South Indian, you know, hardcore Tamilian Iyer family, that was never like we didn't know anybody who did that. Right? And that to me sometimes becomes like 90% of the game. If you knew one guy in your family or in your, you know, in your closer friend circle, maybe perhaps your brother's colleague or your uncle's neighbor, somebody, right? Then it becomes kind of easier because then there's a reference point.
Sure.
Your folks have no idea what you're getting into. I mean, you know, you're an Iyer kid, you're supposed to be a chartered accountant, lawyer. You know, whatever. I mean, there are those regular set parts, right?
Yeah.
So, movies were something which we consumed. Back in the day, I remember that friends would chip in money, get like VCR for say 24 hours or 48 hours on the weekend, and watch like 7 or 8 films, and then end up Monday and Tuesday with headaches because we haven't slept.
Okay.
So, remember watching lots of interesting films back then. Operation Daybreak. 90 minutes in Entebbe.
अच्छा, मतलब आप लोग इंटरनेशनल सिनेमा भी कंज्यूम करते थे बचपन में?
वो आसपास वीडियो लाइब्रेरीज हुआ करते थे उस टाइम पे.
अच्छा,
करेक्ट. लाइक होल इन द वॉल वीडियो लाइब्रेरीज हुआ करते थे वहां पे. वो स्टार्टेड ऑफ बिकॉज़ देयर वाज अ लॉट ऑफ इलीगल पॉर्न. करेक्ट. सो इट्स नॉट दैट वी वांट वाचिंग दैट, वी वर आल्सो वाचिंग दैट. करेक्ट. इज हाउ लीगल वाज इट, हाउ इलीगल वाज इट, वी डिडंट नो मैन. करेक्ट. बट द good thing was I kind of started getting interested in 17-18 when I started seeing Sergio Leone films. I started watching I think one of the first films that made an impact on me was The Good, Bad and the Ugly.
Right.
Then strangely we saw, you know, these guys started talking about Lawrence of Arabia. So these big films which are big, so those are the films that I remember that ended up making a a massive impact on me. There were then I remember Pushpak. When I saw Pushpak, I you know, the first thing that struck me is is this even possible? Can you even do a film like this? Where there are no dialogues. I mean, I remember coming home and I got so emotional seeing that film. Because, you know, I mean, you can't help falling in love with Kamal Hassan in the film.
Yeah. वैसे क्या आपने कुणाल ने बात कर रखी है क्या पुष्पक के बारे में? Because he also spoke.
These are things which are, you, I'm telling you, you talk to, funnily, there will be like a bunch of guys who are like-minded.
Sure.
Did Kunal also speak about this to you?
Yeah, actually, he spoke about Kamal Hassan in general and about almost all of his films, including Pushpak as well.
Oh, that's strange because he and I have never had a chat about this.
Yeah.
But I don't find this strange because I know lots of people, when you start talking about this, you realize that I think it's also a function of the time we grew up at the same time, around the same time, right?
Exactly.
So Kamal has impacted us a lot more than, let's say, Rajni has. I like the Rajnikanth who came into the business. When he came into the business, he actually started playing a lot of negative roles. Rajni was a negative character when he came into Tamil cinema.
Okay.
Right. So, and then there was the Malayalam cinema. Unfortunately, being like a Tamilian Iyer boy, from Kerala, right? I could I can kind of get by speaking a little bit of Malayalam. I can understand well. But the moment I open my mouth, anybody can immediately... ये फ्रॉड है ये बंदे को ये पता चल जाए
ओके
मलयालम टू बी फेयर आई कैन सेव माय लाइफ राइट बट बियॉन्ड दैट इज इट क्लियर नाउ
या या
इज दिस क्लियर नाउ हर्षित
या या एब्सोल्युटली एब्सोल्युटली
सो आई कैन स्पीक द लैंग्वेज टू सेव माय लाइफ या बट अपार्ट फ्रॉम आई मीन आई रिमेंबर द काइंड ऑफ फिल्म श्रीनिवासन another Malayalam filmmaker. I think he's a genius. It's so unfortunate that none of the films that they did in the 80s, and I thought 80s was the time when Malayalam cinema kicked ass. And then there was this real low point in the 90s. And then somewhere post 2000, you know, one started again. 2003, 4, 5, maybe. In the last 10, 12 years for sure,
yeah,
it's kind of picked up because a lot of the next generation artists kind of said, no, man, this is crap, man. Anybody can do this. What makes us special? This is a very introspective. So if you look at the kind of films that Rajiv Ravi makes, or the kind of films that, you know, Dilish Potan makes, whether it's Thondi Mudalam Drishakshiyam, which is the crime and witness, Mahesh Inda Pratikaram, or Shyam Pushkaran as a writer, I have a lot of admiration for those guys. Including my art director who worked on my film, who went on to make it. So the art director of Loot Case, while we were working on Loot Case, I would remember telling, you know, I've written a script and read a picture to somebody. I thought it started off as a joke, then I realized it was serious. And then he went and pitched it to Saubin and Suraj, and then they ended up making it. I think it made a lot of films. Now I've lost Ratish as an art director.
Oh, wow.
It's just he's way too busy as a filmmaker now in Kerala.
That's amazing.
Right? Also, he... Yeah, and my cameraman, Sanu, his film's going to release now on the 27th of March, if I'm not mistaken. He wrote a film. So I'm saying that I was well taken care of. In the sense, it's always a good bet to work with people who are smarter than you. It's always a good bet to work with people who are more intelligent than you. You might be the director and you might still take the final call, but you just get a lot more options and choices from people. The moment you identify a problem for him, saying, "Mere ko ye solve karna hai, toh main soch raha hoon, aisa karun." So immediately this girl say, "How about doing it like this?" And immediately this girl say, "No, how about doing it like this and then covering it from here like this?" You're still the director. You're still taking the call. But the thing is, if you have wise generals, battle scarred generals who've gone more to war than you have, right? Then, you know, it's always a smart idea to listen.
Yeah.
And then arrive at your own decision. I mean, you know what I'm saying? But, so those are the kind of people I was working with in my project. And coming back to the films that really impressed us. Yeah, I mean, it would have to be, let me put it like filmmakers as against films.
Oh, sure. Yeah, absolutely.
Let's look at, I kind of stumbled upon Shyam Benegal at the age of 17 or 18, his work, I'm sorry.
Yeah.
Shyamji's work, Mandi is the one film which I had seen pretty early.
Okay.
Which I think is one of the funniest films I've seen.
Yeah.
It's a satire. It makes you laugh. It makes you cry. It makes you ponder. It makes you think about. It takes you into a journey. It takes you, you're kind of besides yourself. And that's the trick, no? I mean, that's entertaining. No? I mean, I forgot myself. I forgot my messages. I forgot I was hungry. I forgot to take a leak. And I sat and I experienced the journey. Correct. Sahi Paranj Pe. If you see Katha, and if you see Chashme Badur, and if you see Sparsh.
Yeah.
And they're three different films. Absolutely. They're three different genres. And then the kind of work she did in television. Then Srinivasan for sure. You know what, I'm probably forgetting like a million other people here, man, but I'm just saying that I mean, then of course a little later in life I started making conscious choices of watching a lot of Hitchcock, a lot of Truffaut, watched you know, a lot of Woody Allen, right? Stanley Kubrick. I mean, the only photograph in my office is that of Stanley Kubrick.
Okay.
That's the only black and white picture which I remember. It's like a proper photo print which I bought from a place in London many years ago. I'm looking through,
through the lens. Right.
Bearded guy. There's one, you know, it's a largest print that I have in the office. I haven't seen it. I think when they renovated it, I hope they haven't thrown it out. They don't know how valuable it is. Not just in terms of monies, but you look at that every day and you tell yourself, here's a man who's done this.
Yeah.
For me, the deal is one guy has done it. Right. Then you can aim too. Somebody has done it before. Correct. Then you might have the ability and the craft and the wit and the intelligence and the gumption to go beyond that. But that's the next stage. The first stage is to, you know, you can at least, I mean, some of the best writers in the world, some of the best filmmakers in the world will tell you, it's always good to imitate. Learn to imitate. But craft comes in when you conceal the origin. Creativity lies in absolutely concealing what the origin is.
Right.
It is the same stories, Harshit. At the end of the day, if you realize.
I know, for sure.
Experiencing anything that billions of people who live walked the planet before us haven't experienced.
Yeah.
Right. Every emotion that you're experiencing today, whether it's love, hate, jealousy, anger, whatever those navrases are today, and you know the Westerners are even more limited in their vocabulary.
Mm-hmm.
But we have a lot of in-betweens, right? For example, when you eat a lot of South Asian food, there's something called umami, which they don't have. Right. I mean, they don't know what umami is. It's sour. It's not sour. Umami is not sour. Umami is umami. Right. And so if you look at Karun Ras and if you look at Vira Ras, right, there's a whole stream of, you know, science of school of music called Tumri, which is just about separation. Correct. So when you consider all that, you realize that it's nice to tell stories which have, or nice to watch works of filmmakers who can take you on any one of these journeys. And the only thing, it's not that I don't like watching horror films. William Friedkin, the guy who made The Exorcist, I think he made some three or four films and like at least two or three of them won Oscars.
Correct.
Right. So I think William Friedkin made The Exorcist. I think he made The French Connection. So there are lots of guys. So then once you start, it's like how I liken it to this generation kids, when they listen to music, my daughter started listening to pop music because it's familiar. She switches on YouTube. It's there in Vimeo. It's there in, you know, it's there in. And then she enjoys it. And then she kind of goes back and she says, you know, I remember my older one saying, The Man Who Sold the World, such a great song by Nirvana. And I looked at her and said, you know, The Man Who Sold the World was not by Nirvana at all. That is by, you know, David Bowie. I said, really? David Bowie? David Bowie sung that song? Yeah, let me go back and check. And now, the moment she taps into David Bowie, she realizes actually he's not the only guy of that era. There's also The Who, there's also The Floyd, Pink Floyds of the world. There's also a whole lot of other musicians. And next thing you realize that Pink Floyd actually didn't come from Pink Floyd. They came from blues musicians. And so the journey is always inward. So that's how you make the journey.
Yeah.
And then you start, you kind of make a journey inward and inward into Bill Wilder. You go back into, you know, some hardcore filmmakers back, like, you know, some of those names, this generation. I don't take any pride in saying will not know, but they should know.
Absolutely.
You know, so that's the trick, man. I mean, going to Oscar Wilde. What am I talking about? Who's the guy who made shit? How can I forget? Who's the guy who made what's Rosebud, man?
Which one?
Citizen Kane. Citizen Kane. Orson Welles. Sorry.
Orson Welles, yeah.
Orson Welles. Yeah. You start. Is that Orson Welles?
Yeah, sir. Orson Welles. Citizen Kane.
Right? Orson Welles. Is that or... Who's the guy who wrote 1984? That's not Orson Welles.
No. Okay. I know why you're getting confused. The reason is that his name is George Orwell. And that's George Orwell.
Right. So I'm saying you start journeying into that time and you start realizing there are styles, there are filmmakers, there's storytelling. Ingmar Bergman. You keep going into it. It's a trip there. It's a trip. And then you realize that there's so much to learn from so many of these guys. And why are they artists? Because they did things which there is one way of doing it. And then there is their way of doing it.
Mm-hmm.
So at all points in time, when you make films, you keep looking at, achha, ye dialogue hai, ye screen hai, ye scene hai, ye screenplay hai. You start going, it's inevitable. You go back to your head and keep wondering, ki, yaar, lekin maine to film, jo, the films I have seen, maine jo film mein dekhi, uske andar to ye aisa hota hai. अब अगर आप उसको वैसा करोगे तो आपसे बड़ा बेवकूफ और कोई नहीं, आपसे बड़ा आलसी और कोई नहीं. You are just not trying hard. And that's just not the case with the scene. You need to do that with the overall film. So you start realizing after doing a lot of study, what is it that people really come to value? What people like is, you know, there are times when somebody is telling you a joke and you want to stop him because you heard that joke before. But then you kind of don't, and you slowly start smiling because you like the way he's saying it. And people say ki wo apni masala dal ke bol raha hai wo. Wo kya hai? Wo actually uski awaaz hai wo. It's just his voice.
Yeah.
So when you say stories with your own voice, which basically means you also need to do a little journey in terms of, yaar main kaun hu? Main angrez hu. अब ए आर रहमान को बुलाया गया है, फर्ज कर लो ए आर रहमान को बुलाया गया है ग्रामी अवार्ड्स में परफॉर्म करने, तो वो लेड ज़ेप्पेलिन की कश्मीर नहीं बजाएगा वो, जा जा जान, या गन्स एंड रोज़ेस नहीं बजाएगा वो, अपनी कुछ गीत बजाएगा वो, या उसको बोला गया आप कुछ भी बजा सकते हो, ही विल प्ले समथिंग इंडियन बिकॉज दैट्स हिज वॉइस, वो उसकी पहचान है, उनकी पहचान वो है. फिर अगर हम वहां जाके वो चीज, वो इट तो बेसिकली ट्राइंग टू do a film in the way somebody else does it is just the same as that. It feels wrong. It feels phony. Just because I've been called for an interview in a Westerner show on a late night show, if I start speaking in an accent, right? Depends if you live there, if you genuinely had the accent and, you know, or sometimes you might even do it with the intent of, that's a way to connect with the local audience.
Yeah.
So there's a correct way in which you do it. Let's say I went and did it like, yeah, when I was here in America, I really liked it. If I start talking like that, बेवकूफ बोलेगा यार तुमको बंदा. You will become a spectacle.
Yeah.
Correct. You will become, people won't laugh at what you're saying. People will laugh at you. Correct. So these are the differences. I think over the years, the filmmakers that I saw and I learned to appreciate, the Coen brothers, for example, are people who had a voice.
Yeah.
People who had their own voice and they were doing things their own way. And you start liking that even about actors. You start liking that about cameramen because you start getting into the art of it and saying, you know, this shot could have been like this, but he's done it so differently, man. That's so beautiful. And sometimes you make a note of it. What you're doing is you're not copying it. You're basically setting a benchmark for yourself. Correct. And also making sure that don't repeat that. If you repeat that, you do it in a way where nobody will be able to catch you. So I think it's a very pertinent question which you asked, what are your influences in terms of films? But Harshit, fact is, I didn't make my first ad film till the time I was 30 years old. So I worked in advertising agencies.
20?
I was 30 when I made my first film.
Okay.
I was my first promo. I was working in a channel then. I used to write for them. So I believe that I could write, but like they said, nothing in life goes waste. So for a whole lot of friends and family and folk who thought that I was wasting time watching movies, it somehow came handy.
Yeah.
Right. So somehow it's a little easier for me to pull out a scene from my memory and say, "Yaar, aisa ek similar situation hua tha. Scene nahi, kahani nahi." There's a little deja vu in terms of how I remember somebody else doing it, and that becomes benchmark. You can either copy it and say, yaar, duniya mein kisko pata nahi, but I don't think we live in that age today where you can get away with it. Aapne kuch ek chura liya, dal diya udhar, aur kisi ne pakda nahi, aapko ye chance bahut kam hai.
Bilkul, bilkul.
Lekin karte hain, hamare log abhi bhi karte hain ye log.
Ek
level of besharmi se karte hain log.
Nahin sir, meko aapki ye baat bahut interesting lagi ki the art isn't concealing the origin. Kyunki, matlab, copy Tarantino bhi karta hai apni, almost sari films mein, itte sari shots. And a lot of them are very similar also, but still people don't call him out for theft, because because he adds his own voice to it as well. I mean, what are your thoughts on that? Do you Tarantino?
I think it's I okay. Tarantino is another guy. I'm sure. Like I said, I've missed out a million guys out there. Tarantino is another one guy. I mean, he's one for. You might like his films, you might not like his films, but you can't fault him for originality.
Yeah.
And sometimes originality is just the way you tell the story. It could be the same Ghisapita story, it's a revenge story. Kill Bill is a revenge story. Yeah? Hmm. And it's as filmy as it can get. Yeah? Correct. Zakhmi Sher. Jitendra ki film, Zakhmi Sher. वही सब एलिमेंट्स उसके अंदर और वो लोग भी वही करते हैं जस्ट दैट वो कहीं कसर रह जाती हो
हाँ
समथिंग यू डोंट गो ऑल आउट एंड से इट लाइक सम ऑफ द 70s 80s फिल्म्स इन व्हिच यू सिट एंड वॉच इट फुल्ली रिवेटेड यू बिलीव्ड इन द वर्ल्ड यू बिलीव्ड इन एवरी एस्पेक्ट ऑफ इट करेक्ट नाउ व्हेन यू एनालाइज की वो क्या बेवकूफ था वो उसके अंदर मुझे क्या पसंद आई थी बट नो I'm saying at that point in time when somebody is watching the film, did he believe every bit of it? Or did he want to believe? I know sometimes that the hero is a strong guy and this one villain is going to like, you know, go walk up to his place and then challenge him and the hero will turn around and sock him. I know that's going to happen. Lots of these beats are very similar. A boy meets a girl. Boy meets girl, boy gets girl. That used to be like the mantra of 80s film till somebody came along and said, boy meets girl. Boy falls in love with girl and then they die. They don't get each other. And that's Ek Dooje Ke Liye. And then that becomes Kayamat Se Kayamat Tak. Correct. And then you realize, wait a second, actually, this is Romeo and Juliet. Because Romeo and Juliet's love never gets consummated. Right, so when you consider that, you realize that there's a lot to learn from history, there's a lot to learn from. So when you do that, right, when you realize ki, us time ke liye bande ne kya correct kar kiya hai. Aap kya kar rahe ho? Duniya wahan se abhi, I mean, I think ek dusre ke liye banne ke baad kareeb 35 saal to kahin nahi gaye. I think it's an 83, 84 film, if I'm not mistaken. Yeah. If you look at that, they suddenly change the game.
Yeah.
Right. So, there'll be more films made with, you know, boy trying to fall in love with girl, more romantic films that'll be made, right? So, it's with a romantic base, basically. And maybe the guy will get the girl. I mean, maybe the guy won't get the girl. And maybe the way the guy won't get the girl wouldn't be a case where one person, the two of them die. It could be just one person who dies. Could be the girl who actually killed him. Maybe it was a revenge story. So I'm just saying that there are ways and means of skinning that cat. You know, many ways to skin that cat, right? I think watching good cinema just helps you set your benchmarks. Right? Tells you, ki, yaar, ye thinking. It's like watching a game of chess. Many ways of approaching that. But you realize some guys are actually good at it. Man, I wouldn't have done that. That's quite cool. That's not a direct approach, but it feels like he's going to lose. But you know what? Suddenly pulls out his rook from the side and you know what? That's how he's... So, approaches. There are many ways of approaching it. I mean, if you see stories of Josh Whiteskin, which is now playing right now on Netflix. It's called Innocent Moves. And then there's people like Bobby Fischer, whether it's Queen's Gambit. You just realize there are so many ways to do something.
Right,
keep watching films, you keep yourself abreast of, and to me, that's like sharpening your wits. That's like understanding more ways. So, as filmmakers, you're constantly looking at people who are pushing the envelope, you know, and sometimes you'll have a great idea, but you will not be able to employ it with this audience because your storytelling is very different, the story is very different. Sometimes limited by the actors that come on board because it becomes a certain kind of a film. Therefore, you can't get too avant-garde about the way you tell the story. You know, there are times when a producer will say, hey, bhai, bahut zyada intellectual mat baniyo. Hai na? To, thoda apan logo ko samajh mein hai, waisa karte hai kuch. But I think, having said that, there are still ways and means of doing that differently.
सर कोई रीसेंट टाइम्स में है फिल्म मेकर्स या फिर कोई फिल्म जो आपने रिसेंटली देखी हो डिस्कवर करी हो जो विच रियली लाइक स्टूड आउट फॉर यू विच रियली अपील टू यू रीसेंट टाइम्स में आपने कोई कंट्री का ऐसा सिनेमा डिस्कवर किया हो जो आपने पहले नहीं किया था प्रोबेबली
मतलब
या फिर आप ऐसा बोलो कि ऐसी कोई फिल्म्स हैं जो कि आप लोगों को रेकमेंड करना चाहोगे कि लाइक इवन फ्रॉम द
बहुत सारी फिल्म्स यार जैसे कि मैं ईरानियन फिल्म्स तो मैं हर बंदे को देखने कहता हूँ हर बंदे को देखने कहता हूँ क्योंकि वो उसके अंदर उनके तो इतने इतने पाबंदियां हैं उनको
हाँ बिल्कुल
दे कांट शो दिस दे कांट डू दैट ये नहीं और उसके अंदर वो बंदा आपको एक दुनिया के अंदर लेके जाता है और आपको मतलब गिला देता है या तो रुला देता है या तो हंसा देता है या तो डरा देता है आपको है ना तो असगर फरादी एंड दीज आर पीपल हु आर ऑफ दिस जनरेशन बट इफ यू वांट टू कंसीडर उनके पूर्वज उनके एंसेस्टर्स लाइक यू नो द गाइस बिफोर देम
राइट
सो लुक एट पीपल लाइक मोहसिन मकबूल बर्ग यू लुक एट अब्बास कायरोस्तामी जाफर पनाही मेड कपल ऑफ आई एम नॉट श्योर इफ ही इज कंसिस्टेंटली मेड
जाफर पनाही इज जस्ट रेलेवेंट बिकॉज़ लाइक ही वाज प्रोबब्ली वन ऑफ द फ्यू वंस जिनके ऊपर सबसे ज्यादा क्रैकडाउन हुआ था गवर्नमेंट का because he was almost put to house arrest for a very long time so
correct
and he correct. Still continued making films even when he was in the house arrest like while he was in the house arrest even then he made a documentary apne phone pe shoot karke I mean he's just an interesting filmmaker in that sense I personally feel
no totally so I'm just saying that if you go a little further back I think there was an Armenian filmmaker called Parajanov and he's somebody that has been a huge influence on Tarsem. Tarsem for anybody in advertising is God because Tarsem is that Indian filmmaker who went and he cracked it.
Right.
वो दिल्ली में उसने कुछ पढ़ाई वढ़ाई की वो बंदा हिमालय के फोटोज वगैरह में कहीं रहता था वो और in the 90s he became like the most he became even more expensive than Ridley Scott.
Wow, really?
वो yeah he was Tarsem was huge. Tarsem was like आपको dates नहीं मिलते थे Tarsem उसने मुझे पता है कि एक तारसेम के डेट्स नहीं मिलते थे और एक फोटोग्राफर हुआ करता था मेरे ख्याल से जर्मन फोटोग्राफर था एक बंदा उसका नाम है नादव कांदेर ये दो लोगों की डेट्स नहीं मिलते थे तो इफ यू लुक एट समटाइम्स माइथोलॉजी आर ओन माइथोलॉजी आर ओन यू नो इफ यू जस्ट फोकस ऑन आर ओन स्टोरी टेलिंग योर ओन फोकलोर लाइक आई कीप टेलिंग दिस टू अ लॉट ऑफ पीपल यार कि Like one of the regrets that all of us have is our kids don't speak our language. Right? They don't speak our mother tongues. There's so much that you will learn which is passed down from the ages, from your ancestors. Jaise hum kehte hain ki wo nach na jaane aangan tedha. Aaj kisko bol ke dikhao aur koi bachcha bol le easily ki haan mujhe pata hai iska kya matlab hai. स्कूल में मैंने सीखी है बट उसके उसका एटिमोलॉजी क्या है वेयर डज इट कम फ्रॉम व्हाट्स द हिस्ट्री ऑफ इट व्हाट्स द रूट ऑफ इट करेक्ट व्हाट्स द हिस्ट्री यू नो यू स्टार्ट अंडरस्टैंडिंग देयर इज अ स्टोरी बिहाइंड इट करेक्ट सो ऑल दोस थिंग्स हैपन व्हेन यू स्पीक अ सर्टेन लैंग्वेज एंड नॉट जस्ट हिंदी स्पीक योर डैम मदर टंग यू नो सो आई एम जस्ट सेइंग दैट देन वंस यू स्टार्ट फोकसिंग ऑन योर मदर टंग व्हेन फोक्स कम होम यू स्टार्ट रियलाइजिंग All the folks that come up, that's a cosmos, man. You don't need to know how, you know, when you suddenly, what is it that I'm liking about The Crown, for example, when I'm watching on Netflix. I'm looking at that and saying, man, these guys are all supposed to be like people from, you know, of royal blood. But you behave exactly like my Aunt Lakshmi here. Right? Or this guy is just like my neighbor that my Aunt Lakshmi spoke about. Aunt Lakshmi had this really petty neighbor and this guy is behaving exactly like that. So when you start focusing and doing that journey inward, you start spending time in your community and you start realizing when somebody tells you, yaar, ye jo hamara jo banda jo na, hamara dost banke ghum raha hai wo actually hai nahi itna jo ban raha hai wo to. Samajhiye na? So you realize ki hum log stories ke beech mein jee rahe hai yaar. But so much to learn from that and you're just not listening. You're just not watching.
Yeah.
Correct. So the writer for Loot Case, Kapil, if you, there's this, you know, famous theory that my producer has about us. All three of us, Ameya, my producer, say that all three of us will be sitting in the same spot, in the same restaurant, watching three guys talking about some incident. The number of inferences that Kapil will pull out of it will be far more, and the number of insights that he'll go. Do you realize what he was saying? He actually meant this, but if he had meant that, he would have said it differently. Achha, ye toh maine socha nahi yaar. So there's film taking place all around us.
Right.
Right. There's a lot of stuff taking place all around. I mean, every guy who's walking on the street is dealing with some conflict. There is a movie going on in his head. Amir Khan or Salman Khan is not the hero of that film. He's the hero of the film. Regardless of what kind of an asshole he is, what kind of a bad guy he is. Right. He'll still feel that mere saath ye ho raha hai yaar, to main ab kaise ladu uske saath. Ab aise bande ko tumne theater mein bitha ke uska problems bhula diya, to fir craft hai yaar.
Yeah.
Alag level ka craft hai. Aur wo it's not something which you know you can do very easily.
Yeah.
So a lot of respect for people who can manage to make me, you know, forget myself.
Yeah.
And then if you look at people like James Cameron, what did he do in Avatar? You are rooting for the alien. You are telling the alien, "Maar, hai to maar isko, maar is aadmi ko maar sala, jitna chahiye isko yaar." Think about it; it's so counterintuitive to
absolutely
the way we live.
Absolutely,
hai na? Asur aur insaan ke beech mein jab ladai ho rahi hai, when you see Mars attacks or you see Independence Day, you want the humans to win, yaar. Correct. But the way he's gone about humanizing humans and saying that these humans jo hai na, ye bahut harami kisam ke hote hain yaar, ye jahan bhi jaate hain na, ye wahan pe apna gandgi phailate hain, ye virus jaisa spread ho jate hain ye log. Aur resources ko deplete karte hain, and then that's, and here are a bunch of guys who are
worshipping their nature.
Or but yeah, they are doing what we should be doing.
Correct.
Not only have we bugged up planet Earth, going to their solar system and we're screwing up everything there. For what? For money. For artificial shit. For gold, which has no value. As a metal, gold has no industrial use. But we're all chasing. So we know what logic is. You know what logic is. You know you shouldn't be smoking. You know you shouldn't be drinking. You shouldn't be doing drugs. You shouldn't be eating too much. Too much of sweets. Right? But yet, here we are. We have friends who do exactly that. The most illogical thing.
Yeah.
They smoke when they shouldn't be smoking. There is a, there's a moving violation. As a human, you know what I'm saying?
Yeah.
There's a guy who goes to the gym in the morning, but in the evening he smokes up and he drinks. I've done that. I've gone to the gym and I've come back in the evening and, you know, friends have landed up. We open a bottle of wine and I know my trainer will tell me, bro, you're wasting everything you've done in the gym by drinking in the evening. So everybody is a story in that sense. And I'm sorry, man, I'm sounding like some expert here. I'm not. I'm just discovering. I'm just sharing.
Absolutely.
You know, some of the things which have fascinated me. So it's not just movies that you learn from. If you also keep your eyes and ears open, right, you start seeing stories in and around you.
Yeah.
Right. And maybe the maybe it's not a story in itself, but there are traits that some of the people that you interact with that show you that becomes a character in the film. Or a certain approach that somebody used when you were dealing with him. Right. There's, like, for example, there's a guy who's supposed to be, you know, supposed to be doing a certain part of my office. It's like this guy who's supposed to put an awning to my balcony and we paid him the money and you know, I know this guy is conning me. And I know he's run away with the money. But every time I call him, he takes my call and I tell him, ab kya ho gaya? OPG, ab kya ho gaya? Aap aane wale the kal. Sir, main kya batao, sir? Durbhagya mere से चार कदम आगे चल रही है. पिछले बार उसको कॉल किया, ओपी सिंह अपना फोन नहीं उठा रहा, क्या प्रॉब्लम क्या है? सर, आप आपका पैर ऊपर करके देखिए, आपको नीचे ओपी सिंह नजर आएगा, हुकुम हुजूर. ऐसे बात करते हो? ये क्या कैरेक्टर है यार?
बिल्कुल बिल्कुल
जबरदस्त कैरेक्टर है. मतलब आप इसको गाली दे ही नहीं सकते हो. बट ये एकदम मतलब तेलू बंदा है, इतना तेल लगा के रखा है कपड़े में कि आप उसको पकड़ ही नहीं सकते हो कभी. वेरी ऑयली कैरेक्टर, यू नो व्हाट आई एम सेइंग, यू विल नेवर बी एबल टू कैच हिम. उसको पकड़ लिया तो वो कुछ
गॉट इट
टेक्निकल हैच मार, मतलब एक एस्केप हैच मार के निकल जाएगा. Right, so sometimes you know you just look at some of these guys and then you know my writers and I will keep discussing. You know what? I found this guy who spoke like this. So it's always nice to be in the company of people who trip on things like this. Right.
You
know, so if you forget it, he'll remember it the next time when you're writing a story. You remember this guy you met once. एक और बंदा है जो हाँ में हाँ मिला दे रहे थे. अब उसको कुछ भी बोलो कभी भी ना नहीं बोल सकते. अब ऐसा करने का कैसे रहेगा? बहुत मस्त रहेगा सर, बहुत सही रहेगा. और उसके साथ हम लोग ये भी कर सकते हैं और वो भी कर सकते हैं. एक्चुअली मेरे को वो खराब लग रहा है, वो नहीं करते, मत कीजिए सर, बहुत ही खराब है, नहीं करना चाहिए. एक्चुअली आप सही बोल रहे हैं, आप इनफैक्ट आपको उसकी ऑपोजिट करनी चाहिए. अच्छा क्या करना चाहिए? जैसे कि ऐसा कुछ कर रहे हैं मैं उसको कहूंगा तो करे हाँ सर बिल्कुल सर वैसा करना चाहिए, वैसा करते जाओगे ना सर. एंड नाउ विल टेल यू द एग्जैक्ट ऑपोजिट. सो ही इज बेसिकली नॉट डिसएग्रीइंग विद यू.
या
correct, and then you realize that what has he contributed to the conversation? Nothing. He just made a lot of noise. Amazing character.
Yeah.
Correct. So a lot of these characters that I like to write about, I like to basically put in our films are people we know.
Yeah.
But you have to go and know them. You have to make an effort to go and know them.
Yeah.
Correct. So sometimes you know you're culpable of. You can accuse us of sitting in an ivory tower. कहाँ बैठा है मैं club में बैठ के लिख रहा हूँ. क्लब में जिंदगी नहीं दिखाने देने वाली है. गो आउट देयर ऑन द रोड, सिट इन द रिक्शा. द काइंड ऑफ कैरेक्टर्स दैट माय राइटर कपिल कीप्स टेलिंग मी, यार आज मेरे को ना आज एक ऐसा रिक्शा वाला मिल गया यार, मेरे को आज ऐसा एक बंदा मिल गया यहाँ पे जो मेरे साथ ऐसी बात करने लगा. करेक्ट. सो आई रिमेम्बर द अदर डे आई वाज गोइंग टू द ऑफिस, जस्ट राइट आउटसाइड माय ऑफिस एक रिक्शा वाला और एक सवारी के साथ मतलब बहस हो रही थी. अरे मैं कह रहा हूँ कि यहाँ तक आते थे मालाड़ से, यहाँ तक आते थे हो जाता ना सर 180 हो जाता ना, तो मतलब 180 कैसे बात कर रहे हो? तो मैं ऐसे जैसे देखा तो उसने बोला साहब अब 180 रुपया नहीं होता क्या मालाड़ से इधर तक? तो बोला हाँ. मैं अभी आप भी देखो ना इधर आइए ना, अभी ये बंदा मेरे को क्या बोल रहा है, ये बंदा मेरे को बोल रहा है कि मैं एकदम ऐसा बेमान आदमी हूँ, आपको देख के मेरे को बेमान लगता है सर, इधर को भगवान का फोटो है इधर, आपको लगता है मैं झूठ बोलता हूँ? आदमी जब झूठ बोलेगा सर भगवान को, आप बोले अभी टाइम पास मत कर, बता मेरे को कितने हुए पैसे. पता नहीं चला मेरे को ही पता नहीं चला कि कैसे उसने मेरे को अंदर खींच लिया और मैं भी बेवकूफ घुस गया. आई एम मीडिएटिंग दो लोगों की लड़ाई जिनको मैं जानता ही नहीं हूँ ना, मेरा कभी इनके साथ लाइफ में कुछ होने वाला है. अब मैं देखता हूँ कि ये इसको फिल्म मेकिंग में कहाँ यूज किया जाए यार. बहुत सारे लोग होते हैं जो सेटअप करते हैं फिल्म में, ये है दुनिया, ये है कहानी, है इनसे मिलिए, ये है इनसे मिलिए, वो है. कट्टू आप कॉन्वर्सेशन मतलब एक फिल्म ओपन हो गई और दो लोग बात कर रहे हैं गेरे की और राजेश पता है हाँ बहुत शरीफ बन के घूमता है, चोर एक नंबर का. मुझे पता है वो लड़कियों को कैसे देखता है, वो एकदम ऐसे देखता है वो. अच्छा पर मैंने तो सुना वो वैसा वैसा है. बोला नहीं 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 मैंने तो सुन. फिर तीसरा बंदा बोलता है यार मैंने तो ये भी सुना है कि वो ठगता भी है लोगों को, एक्टर्स को बुलाता है उनको उल्लू बनाता है. तो देन यू आर सडनली इनटू राजेश. नोबडी सेड कि इनसे मिले ये है राजेश. राजेश जो है फिल्म मेकर. अब आपको इन कॉन्वर्सेशन से पता चल गया कि राजेश फिल्म मेकर है, एडवर्टाइजिंग प्रोडक्शन करता है, हसलर है, मॉडलों को फुसलाता है, क्लाइंट को टोपी घुमाता है. करेक्ट. अब किसी ने नरेट नहीं किया इसके बारे में, बट कैसे मतलब आपको खींच लिया उन्होंने उसके अंदर. करेक्ट. अब टोटली डिपेंड करता है कि वो तीन लोग इंटेलिजेंट लग रहे हैं या गॉसिपी लग रहे हैं या बेवकूफ हैं ये लोग. या एक बंदे के साथ एक्चुअली हुआ, वो बंदा रो रहा है और रो रो के कह रहा है कि मेरे साथ ऐसे हुआ. तो अब राजेश नेगेटिव बन गया. कितना क्लेवरली फिल्म मेकर उसको पेंट कर रहा है, ये नेगेटिव पेंट कर दिया उसको. करेक्ट. सो देयर आर सो मेनी अप्रोचेस दैट यू नो आई एम वेरी फैसिनेटेड बाय ऑल काइंड्स ऑफ गॉसिप, आई एम वेरी फैसिनेटेड बाय ऑल काइंड्स ऑफ एनीबॉडी हु हैज अ स्टोरी टू टेल. आई एम अ बिग सकर फॉर दैट. मैं तो तुरंत सुनने बैठ जाता हूँ ये बंदा कैसे कहेगा यार अब. एंड इट्स सम ऑफ द मोस्ट अनलाइकलीस्ट पीपल who end up, you end up listening to stories from.
Yeah.
You know, so I think an aggregation of all that ends up becoming your voice.
Yeah.
If you remember to then apply the lessons or apply the people that you met in your life, and if you kind of put them in there, then it becomes even your life. It becomes your storytelling approach. Then knowing a little bit of technique, yahan pe wide jao, yahan pe close jao. वो आप किसको भी पूछ लो, कोई बंदा विद क्लैरिटी नहीं बता सकता कि ऐसे शॉट में ना यहाँ पे वाइड किया जाता है, तो फिर गलत है वो। अगर नॉर्मली लोग ऐसा करते तो आपको वो नहीं करनी चाहिए, राइट? सो आई डोंट नो, आई मीन आई थिंक मोर देन एनीथिंग दिस इज बीन मोर ऑफ अ फ्री, अ वेरी फ्री विलिंग काइंड ऑफ अ कन्वर्सेशन ऑन अप्रोचेस।
या सर,
सो यू नो रीडिंग कैन डू दैट टू यू समटाइम्स।
या
यू नो, सो आई डू अ लॉट ऑफ रिसर्च ऑन व्हाट आई हैव टू रीड, बिकॉज़ आई थिंक व्हेन आई रीड इट स्टेज इन माय हेड।
एब्सोल्युटली,
if you read crap now, you start talking crap. If you hang around with churches now, you'll become a churchy. If you hang around with a bunch of guys who drink every second day, you will drink. If you hang around with a bunch of guys who are about good reading, then you become the average of that. You become now the average of the five people you hang around with.
Yeah,
you have to also then research and say, what are the books that I want to read, man? A lot of it is non-fiction. Now I'm forcing myself to start reading a lot of fiction. Sorry, I'm not sure if a lot of what I spoke was even relevant to.
No, no, sir, absolutely relevant.
Just sounded like a lot of like a crock of shit.
नहीं 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 सर, क्या बात कर रहे हो, मतलब बहुत ज्यादा रेलिवेंट था, और एंड आई मीन दिस इज एग्जैक्टली द काइंड ऑफ स्टफ दैट पीपल ऑल्सो कम टू द पॉडकास्ट टू लर्न अबाउट, बिकॉज दैट्स व्हाट एवरी पर्सन इज ट्राइंग टू फिगर आउट राइट नाउ ऑल्सो ना, मतलब स्पेशली ऑल द आर्टिस्ट।
यार अपनी अपना तरीके से करो।
हाँ एग्जैक्टली, पर वही है कि एक एक व्हेन इट कम्स फ्रॉम समबडी हु हैज gone through that experience, or jab unse ek insight milti hai to fir the rasta becomes a little easier, aur ha matlab kyunki ye wali cheez bhi pata hona bahut zaruri hai ki matlab why do we need our own voice, like what's the significance of that as well, and I think that's something that
har stand up comedian ko dekh lo na yaar, har stand up comedian ko dekh lo, wo content alag hi, content hi sirf alag nahi hota hai, sometimes the content is pretty much the same, but wo jo delivery karta hai wo, usko pata hai uski strengths kya hai. अब केनी सेबेस्टियन को देख लो यार, कमाल का बंदा है यार, गाना गा के आपको हंसाता है यार वो, गिटार विटार बजाते हंसाता है वो आपको। नवीन को देख लो यार आप, या फिर कितने जितने भी लोग हैं, मतलब नवीन रॉबर्ट्स, राइट, इज दैट हिज नेम, नवीन रिचर्ड, सॉरी, या आई मीन देयर आर अ टन ऑफ पीपल आउट देयर अगेन मैन, एंड देन यू सी एक वो बंदा था जो जिसको मैंने लूडो में देखा हो, मेरे मेरे ख्याल से उसने एक मुंबई का ब्राह्मण का उसका कुछ एक स्टैंड अप था यार, तो यू सी द डिलीवरी विद व्हिच दे डू, सो दे नो देयर स्ट्रेंथ्स, दे नो देयर वीकनेसेस, एंड इट स्टार्ट्स विद स्टोरी टेलिंग। देयर आर अ लॉट ऑफ यंग एडीज आर आस्किंग सर व्हाट डज इट टेक, एंड आई टेल देम कैन यू टेल अ जोक, कैन यू होल्ड माय इंटरेस्ट टेलिंग मी अ जोक, देन यू आर अ फिल्म मेकर, एवरीथिंग एल्स इज अ टेक्निकलिटी, एवरीथिंग एल्स इज अ लर्नेबल स्किल, यू नो, यू कैन लर्न टू swim, draw and play music, play an instrument at any age. This has been proven. Correct. But the ability to tell a story,
right,
is something which is very difficult to teach somebody. Yeah. You have to want it bad enough to learn it and do it your way. And your way is the only way. There is no two ways about it. Your way is the only way of doing it. You cannot do it like that. Then you know, why should somebody listen to you?
Yeah.
And they listen to a celebrity. Yeah. Right? So those are some of my two bits. These are things which I am discovering.
Yeah.
Some of these things are, you know, even fun. Some of these things are very painful. Some of these things you learn the hard way.
Yeah.
By making mistakes. And in a line of work, when you make a mistake, there's a cost attached to it. Mm-hmm. There are days you just shoot a couple of scenes, like, you know, I remember even in Lutke's, we shot like a particular scene, and when we put it on the edit, it didn't work. And then he said, you know what, I realized we've not shot it right. Something in the way Kunal did wasn't right. Maybe his look was off, and then, you know, the way he was delivering the line, or the way he felt that the comedy wasn't coming through. And then I spoke to him saying, you know, Kunal, this hasn't turned out right. Then he said, oh shit, then what do we do? He said, let's do it. We'll come back to the same location in about a couple of weeks' time for some stunts, and let's do it at that time. He said, okay, fine, I'll do it. We did it again. I put it in the edit and I realized it's still not working. And that's when my editor pointed out saying, it's an interesting scene, but it feels like a gag because it's not taking the story forward. I take it off.
Correct.
And the film still works. So that's the so the way you learn. So one of the things I again learned, again, which in my process of filmmaking for the first time, is that you write a script. When you write it physically, when you put it on, you know, final draft, right? You're physically writing the act of writing the script, screenplay, dialogue, and everything. That's the first time you write it. When you shoot it, you're writing it again. Because as the writer, the actors, the cameraman, the costume designer, the set maker, they're all interpreting it, and then they are telling the same. And then you realize, 1 second, we don't need to say this because this is very evident. Why is the guy saying this line?
Yeah,
he says, "Main gareeb hu." Are you chawl ke saamne khada aur bol raha hai, "Main gareeb hu." Bolne ki zarurat hi nahi hai. Oh shit, let's get rid of that. That's the second time you write it. And the third and the most important time is when you're editing the film. And you realize that that's the third time you're writing the same film. A lot of what you put in there suddenly is now, for the first time, it's all there in, like, you know, you're getting full perspective of what you've written. And you said, "Fuck, there's so many things which look like crap, man." That's not needed. That's not needed. That feels like a repetition. That feels like I'm saying it twice. So that was another one major learning that you know. Then when I started watching a lot of workshops, reading a lot of experiences of other filmmakers, talking to people, I realized apparently that's the thing, and everybody feels this. आप तीन बार लिखते हो फिल्म, एक बार लिखने के टाइम पे, एक बार शूट करने के टाइम पे, और तीसरी बार जब आप उसको एडिट करते हो. So this was the first time I experienced. It was amazing, man. I mean, I realized that there's so much I don't know. There's just so much I don't know. And I think that's, then you're on that journey, man. You want to know, at the end of the day, you want to know more about yourself and your ability. And I think that's what keeps a lot of people going on. Kya main aisa bhi keh sakta hu? Kya main horror film bana sakta hu? Pure horror. Horrex jaisa bolte hain. Horror and sex. Wo ek genre ban gaya hai. Main matlab sunne mein aata hai. Horror comedy hai. Zombie films agar horror comedy hote hain. Correct?
Yeah.
Ya revenge film. I don't know. I mean, thriller, pure thriller. I don't know. I mean, it's also, maybe it's a very producer-led term where they want to understand genre kya hai bhai, genre kya hai, batao. What is a genre? Wala jo hota hai na. I don't think anybody, I don't know, maybe it works. I have no clue. I mean, maybe, you know, people see a thriller and say, ki, haan, ye toh na, mere ko lagta hai, ye na, ekdam comedy type chal rahi hai. To chalo jaake dekhte hain. Hota hoga.
Yeah.
But in any of these, unless you have your own voice, not going to be fun. I think you should just focus on that.
Yeah.
I'm discovering how much of my voice is fake. I need to start getting into really, really, really asking myself, who am I? What am I going to sound right saying?
Yeah.
Right. So there you go, man.
Chalo, sir, on that note, thank you so much. This has been a huge pleasure. It was such a great chat. I had so much fun.
I hope you had enough material. I think a lot of it is crap, so I have no idea how we are going to edit this.
Arre, nahin, right?
A lot of it sounds like a monologue. Arre, bande ko samne mic de diya tha, kuch bhi bakte gaya hai, ye to ruka hi nahi sala.
नहीं सर, मेरे लिए मेरे को तो सिर्फ फ्री कंटेंट मिल रहा है, मतलब मेरा क्या जा रहा है. लेकिन हाँ, लोगों को तो आदत होती है कुछ ना कुछ बोलने की, तो लेकिन सर, बट एट द सेम टाइम आई एम श्योर दैट इट विल बी एक्सट्रीमली एक्सट्रीमली इनसाइटफुल फॉर एवरीबडी हु लिसंस, एज इनसाइटफुल एज इट वाज फॉर मी. एंड आई हैव लर्नड सो मच टुडे. थैंक यू सो मच अगेन फॉर शेयरिंग ऑल दिस अमेजिंग इनवैल्यूएबल इंफॉर्मेशन एंड योर इनसाइट्स
एंड थिंग्स. आई एम जस्ट शेयरिंग स्टफ व्हिच आई एम डिस्कवरिंग.
या
दिस इज लाइक अ रियली रियली बिग massive map where you can, like, you know, har disha mein chale jao, aapko kuch naya naya dekhne ko milega.
Yeah,
right. So good. I'll look forward to this. Please keep me posted when I want to see what kind of a fool I made of myself.
Anyway, sir, you're too kind, you're too modest. To everybody who listened, who watched, thank you so much for watching. And this is me, Harshit Bansal, signing off from the Humans of Cinema podcast with Mr. Rajesh Krishnan. Thank you,
all the best, bye bye.